I'm Liz Shaw, and I like connecting folks to Appalachia, whether it's through technology or through Appalachian culture. I've been a community organizer since I was 17 years of age. I grew up in Western North Carolina, and I've been involved with many issues that affect communities since I was a teenager. I saw that modeled in my parents and in my friends and family. I could not sit on the sidelines when I saw an issue that really meant something to me. I got involved. And that's just part of my personality. I can't sit back and keep my mouth shut if I feel like there's something I can do to make a difference. Connectivity in Appalachia is a very important issue. It affects all aspects of life. Healthcare, it affects education, it affects business, commerce, it affects political pursuits such as elections. It affects all parts of our lives. And so we need to be as connected to be as competitive as possible with the rest of the state and actually the rest of the world. And when I moved here and found we have very little connectivity and it's not improved over the last 20 years, it started to dawn on me, we need to do something about this. July of 2017, I was fortunate enough to connect with FCC Commissioner Mignon Clyburn, who has since retired. And I was encouraged to tell her some of the connectivity horror stories I had been collecting in this area. When she heard those stories, she said, "I think I need to come down there and talk to the people and know more about what your situation is." So I formed a committee and we put together the Appalachian Ohio West Virginia Connectivity Summit and Town Hall. And we brought in representatives from government officials, we brought in community members, we brought in experts on connectivity. And we had a really good day of learning from each other. But I think one of the most important things that happened is Commissioner Clyburn went back to Washington with our story. And within a week, she was testifying before the House Subcommittee on Communications and Technology on our behalf. When I saw her on television quoting some of the things that we had told her and advocating for us, I have to be honest, I started crying. Since the Connectivity Summit, we've been able to stay in touch with some of the area leaders and some of their plans as to what they're doing. Many of them have told us that they were able to get a foothold on the problem and understand it better because of attending the summit or the town hall. Others have become more politically active and are reaching out to their elected officials. Others are trying to come up with systems where they can provide their own connectivity and not wait around for a major provider to find a business model profitable enough to come into our area. So we're pulling ourselves up by our bootstraps in many areas, and I'm really proud to see that there has been some movement of the needle. All of Appalachia is special to me, from the culture, the music, the scenery, and also the problems of Appalachia. They all mean a lot to me. It runs very deep in my life. To receive the Jenco Award means a lot to me in that I know who Father Jenco was, and I've always admired his story. And when I first saw these awards being given out so many years ago, I was so happy to see someone who lived a life like he led his being memorialized that way. So just knowing who he was and what he stood for as a person and finding out that I'm included in this group is just, more than I can fathom sometimes because I admire him so much. My motto in life is leave everything better than you found it. And if I can do that on any issue or any situation in my community or on a larger scale, I will try to leave something better than I found it if I can.